Mars is a tantalizing place as far as the search for other life in the solar system is concerned. And while not a place where one will find the old visions of Mars to be true, an inhabited world with canals and green men, Mars does remain a possibility for microbial life living under its surface. And this possibility seems to only grow, as hints of what might be seem to come along regularly these days. We know Mars was once a water world, an Earth-like place where simple life might have arisen. Had it done so, it would have been subject to the planet's slow conversion into the cold desert world it is today. But that life could have possibly handled that and adjusted. After all, life here on Earth has no problem existing deep below the surface of the planet, and there's no reason to say that life couldn't do so on Mars. And there are tantalizing hints that there may still be biology going on Mars, things like odd methane readings detected by several probes that might be geological in nature but also might be produced by life. Plus, it may well be that not all water on Mars is frozen. We know now that Mars has a lot of water still locked up in ice, but how much of it might be liquid deep below the surface where it's warmer is unknown. This has been a contentious issue. Features that appear to maybe be briny water seeping out of subsurface aquifers into craters on the surface are now in question. They may just be landslides. But even if those were indicators of liquid water, they would be transient and not stable. But there have been suggestions that stable reservoirs of liquid water could hypothetically exist beneath the surface of Mars. This possibility has recently been strengthened. In a paper by R. Orosei and colleagues at the Italian Space Agency linked below, they detail a potential radar discovery of a reservoir of liquid water beneath the surface of Mars using the European Space Agency's Mars Express spacecraft. By using ground-penetrating radar, they located what appeared to be a change in signal, indicative of liquid water about a mile below the southern polar region of Mars, resembling in some ways lakes of water located beneath the surface of Antarctica here on Earth. This body of water appeared large, about 12.5 miles wide, and while the subsurface lake has not been confirmed, if it's there, in order to remain in a liquid state, the water would need to be significantly salty. But Earth's oceans are salty, and we know that Mars has plenty of salts. This has implications on both the search for past life on Mars, liquid water is the solvent that makes life on Earth possible, but also colonization. We will need water to colonize Mars, and Mars seems to have plenty of it, and maybe not only in the form of ice. And, just maybe, any microbial life that might once have arisen on Mars may have retreated deep below the surface and may yet still have a foothold in those waters. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and instead of ending with my usual utterly shameless book plug and various other things and such, here's a message from Dr. Robert Zubrin, founder of the Mars Society, an organization I very much support.
Hi, I'm Dr. Robert Zubrin. I'm president of the Mars Society. And just this week, it's been announced that scientists have discovered underground water on Mars, which is a habitable environment where there could very well be life. So this has greatly increased people's interest in exploring Mars. And the Mars Society, which I lead, has a convention this summer, August 23 through 26, at the Pasadena Convention Center. It's open to the public. And if people, the discussion there is going to be really exciting. And if people want to come, they can. If you want to see the agenda, it's at www.marssociety.org. Hope you can come.